Hey everybody, thanks for being here. This week we're fishing several lakes around Truckee, California for trout, kokanee, and mackinaw. Now if you want to learn how to catch more fish, stay tuned. I'm Justin Wolf and this is Angler West Television. Historic Truckee, California, not too far from both Lake Tahoe or Reno, Nevada. We're staying at the historic Truckee Hotel, which gives us access to great fishing in several lakes within just a few miles. After a great night in the hotel, we'll find the moon setting over the 8,000-foot elevation Donner Peak, which overlooks Donner Lake. It's a cool, calm morning on Donner Lake, which has kokanee and trout, but today our target is lake trout, or otherwise known as mackinaw. We're with guide Marc Christophel, along with Adam Birdwell and Phil Nichols.
We're out here in beautiful Donner Lake in Truckee, going after some lake trout this morning. It's been fishing really well for them and should have a good morning. We're going to head off to the east side of the lake. Seems like that's where most of the fish have been holding as of recent. This morning we're running with the half-ounce Humdingers. This is a particular pattern I just discovered. It's actually Inger West Nightmare half-ounce Humdinger. We're fishing these pretty tight to the bottom. Probably about 10 or 15 feet off the bottom. The whole purpose of this is you want them close to the bottom, but you don't want to necessarily have them dragging in the bottom or on the bottom. So these have been real productive as of lately. We're going to top it off with a little Procure Bait Waxx and hopefully get into some mackinaw. So what we're going to do is a little bit of a sweet shrimp to start with. We like to put it just right behind here. Seems like it has the best ability to disperse that scent. This particular lure is fantastic for this lake. It represents a little baby kokanee or a little kokanee fry, and that's one of the main food sources for these lake trout. On that lure, you know, I put sweet shrimp on this. Phil's putting a little bit of trophy trout on that one. Again, a leading scent out here with the Tootie Chubs. So it should be good. And you know, one thing that's interesting with this lure, you know, when it was designed, it was intended to go about 3 miles an hour. We found by slowing that down to a mile and a half an hour, it's got a great little wobble like you'd expect from a spoon lure, you know, a bait fish. And every 20, 30 seconds, it'll roll, much like a crip lure, about 2 feet to the side and flutter over there and come back. So very unique action on these guys at slow speeds. So Phil, this morning, we're gonna aim for 120 feet of water. It seems like where they've been holding. Okay. The key to this is if it starts bouncing, we're a little bit off course, let me correct it with the boat rather than, you know, using the downrigger to bring it up and down. We want to keep these as stable as possible. That way, in case a mackinaw is following it, we don't pull it out of their face. This morning, we're seeing fish on the fish finder, some suspended, quite a few on the bottom. We're going after the ones on the bottom. They seem to be a little bit more consistent of bite, not to say that we couldn't target the suspended fish. But as of lately, the ones that are glued to the bottom seem to be the one that's on the bite. Nice and slow, Phil. Remember, the first 50 feet or so, you want them nice and slow so you can get a good fight out of them the whole way, all right? Otherwise, they'll tend to blow it up on you.
Right.
And it's just like reeling up a 2x4, so nice and slow.
Fast enough here, huh?
Yeah, nice slow, a little, yeah, just
tugging pretty good.
Steady pressure, right on. Most of the time we're catching what we call the eater size, 2 to 5 pounds. Certainly we have the opportunity to catch something much larger, but based upon what I'm seeing here, I bet you that's that eater size, 2 to 5 pounds.
Some weight to it.
Gonna bring the rod over to the
side. Now he's getting upset.
Okay. Nice, slow, steady. Main thing is, yep, I can see color. Yeah.
There you go.
Nice eater. All right. Just go ahead and surf him on into the net. All right.
All right.
Good eater. You know, he did blow it up a little bit on us. What we'll probably do is take him and put him on the sequalizer. Send him on back down since we're going to release him. So this fish, I mean, he's definitely a good eater size. It's consensus across the boat. We're going to go ahead and let this fish go. We're going to use this called the Sequalizer. It's big in the rock fishing industry up in Oregon. We've kind of been using it as of recent out here. What we'll do is we'll go ahead and clip this to the downrigger. This latches into his mouth, and we'll set this to go ahead and automatically release at 100 feet. So it'll automatically pressurize that fish or depressurize it. That way, once it releases, it'll be free to swim. Doesn't have to worry about struggling from the surface to get down. All right, we're reaching that 100-foot mark. Let's go ahead and do an auto retrieve on the downrigger. And as you can see, came back up, jaws opened up, automatically released that fish at depth. So a great tool to have on board, especially if you're fishing for Mackinaw, rockfish, anything where they're going to be deep. You know, we don't want them struggling to get from the surface down to 100 feet where they need to be pressurized and equalized.
Welcome to Stampede Reservoir. I'm Justin Wolf. We're just a few miles to the northeast of Truckee in the beginnings of the Great Basin region. Stampede is well known for its great kokanee fishing, but it has excellent rainbow trout as well. Today, Marc Christophel and Adam Birdwell will start off targeting kokanee.
Yeah, so this morning we're out on Stampede Reservoir near Truckee. We're after the early season kokanee. The bite's been great, shallow fishing. So we're gonna work our way out to the channels in front of the islands and then go check a little bit towards the dam. So early season, it's tough to graph them, but we'll get into them, we'll find them. We got three different types of corn. This is gonna be just regular tuna. The black is gonna have tuna with a little bit of corn magic, Procure corn magic. And then this regular silver one is tuna with some Procure UV oil. So something just kind of messing around with and see if that gets some finicky fish to bite. Okay. So help yourself, try any one of them. We'll keep track of which one works.
All tuna here today, huh, Mark?
All tuna. Yeah, you know, tuna's been a great scent for this kokanee, and yeah, we're all in with tuna this morning for sure. So this morning we're gonna put out a few different colors. Orange and pink always seems to be the leader out here. So what we're gonna run is a pink UV sling blade, number three. And then we have this lure that Gary Morales just tied up. It's got the orange tinsel, followed with a Max glow hook on the end. So this has been real productive as of lately. It's, I'm really happy to see a solid color micro lure coming out. It's gonna work real well for us this year.
Over here on this side, same blade that Mark's got going out with a Max Orange Cha-Cha with a little smile blade up front there.
So Adam, I think what we do today is we kind of stagger them. These fish are gonna be in the top 25 feet with water temps as cold as they are. So let's put, you know, 100 foot setbacks thereabouts, and let's you and I stagger them from 25 feet up to 5 feet below the surface.
What's the water temp say on there? It's still pretty cold, yeah, 47 and a half. I thought it went up in the 50s.
Yeah, so it's a little bit colder than we expected on the surface. Surface temp is 47 degrees. So we're thinking, hey, it's probably a good idea to drop the fish hawk down. Let's see if we can find some sort of, you know, a pocket where the temperature is a little bit warmer, maybe where these fish are holding that we're not seeing right now. So go ahead and drop this down on the downrigger and bring it back up and see what it says. See what this has got to offer us. So exactly what we're seeing on the fish finder, 47, almost 48 on the surface. You know, it's actually getting a little bit warmer, Adam, honestly, as we're going down. It looks like the sweet spot's about 15, 10 or 15 with 48 and a half. And then as expected, it's quickly going down from there. But I think what we concentrate in is those 10, 15 foot.
Sounds good. Puts it at 20 feet.
So at 20 feet, it is 48.1. Perfect. So yeah, 48 degrees, 48 and a half. I think that's gonna be our sweet spot. So got our gear kind of staggered correctly, 25 and above. All right, we got one on here. This is on that pink Kokanuts that once again Gary tied up with the trailer glow hook. A tuna with a little sweet shrimp on the blade. Doesn't feel like he's doing a whole lot right now, but yeah, there he is, little guy. That looks to be one of, no, that's a kokanee. Little tiny guy. We'll go ahead and shake him both side. Water temp's cold enough. We can do that. Just if you are going to do this, don't put him in the net. Try not to obviously handle him, and that's as good as it gets right there. When I was bringing that in, when it got close enough, obviously I saw the silver once it got close enough. But on the way in, I thought it was one of these cutthroats that they've been planning out here the last couple years, little 4 or 5 inch cutthroats. It's not uncommon that we catch 4 or 5, 6 of them in a trip. So They'll grow up to be hopefully some big fish one day, but right now they're more or less just a nuisance and still in the corn.
All right, just switched up. All pink. Wasn't down long.
Oh yeah, it's a nice fish. Oh.
There's that pink small blade and the same UV blade there we started with. The small blade adds some flash, just nice combination. The hoochie and you still get the spinner action, so it's a good combination.
Yeah, that's a nice fish. All right. This is a very nice early season kokanee for out here. About 14 inches right here. This is gonna grow up to be about a 17 inch fish. Very, very, very nice quality fish for early May. So hopefully that'll result in some fantastic fishing come late July and then August.
While in Truckee, give yourself a treat and stay at the Truckee Hotel. The historic Truckee Hotel is located right in downtown Truckee. And be sure to eat at Moody's, where the food is always really good. Visit online at truckeehotel.com. Welcome back to Stampede Reservoir, where Marc Christophel and Adam Birdwell are getting this morning's tough kokanee bite figured out. But now, let's take a break from the kokanee and run up to an area that's likely to hold some of Stampede's great rainbow trout. We won't be trolling, but rather casting lures such as the Acme Tackle Kastmasters at the mouth of the Little Truckee, one of Stampede's major feeder streams.
All right, we got one hooked up here. This is looking and feeling like a nice trout. Right back here in the Little Truckee arm of Stampede. Oh yeah, he's a little feisty guy. Oh yeah. Getting a little acrobatic over here. Wow, that is a, oh, he ain't done yet. That is a beautiful trout. Wow. And I tell you what, this Daiwa rod is killer. Wow.
That's a beautiful trout there.
That is a beautiful trout. Yeah, so caught that on the Silver Kastmaster. Just an absolute gorgeous wild trout here. Beautiful. Be gone. So we're back here, Little Truckee arm of Stampede. Just throwing some lures right at the mouth. It's a lot of fun. Had a little sweet shrimp bait wax. Putting a little bit more of that on. This is one of the beauties of this area and this reservoir. You know, you fish for kokanee in the morning, take a time out, come back here, throw a little Kastmaster or some lures for some rainbows, and then go right back at it with kokanee fishing if that's what you like to do. A lot of versatility in these lakes.
Oh, he's a sucker. Got a scrappy little rainbow on here. On that same perch color Kastmaster. Take a look at him. And a safe release. That same color pattern here at Stampede's been real good. So this is the little smaller version, but seem to dig it. Oh, we got a nice one here. He's a dancer. Swimming at, right at me when they do that. He's got a real, like, crazy to catch up to them. Otherwise, they all get slack and come off, but he's nicely hooked. And another look at pretty rainbow there. Here you go, Mark. I'll take that. There we go.
Very pretty.
Nice looking fish there.
Nice job, Adam.
Thank you, sir. I think I might have found where they're hanging out a little bit. There you can see that Kastmaster again there we're using. Nice pretty bow. So just kind of found a little pocket here. Just hooked a fish, so anytime you do that, it's good just to throw right back to the same place and just letting the lure flutter down. 2 or 3 seconds, twitching it, bringing it up quick, letting it fall, twitching, and just making sure there's some action on the lure on the drop. Got one, then two in a row, so go back to the same spot and try it again.
All right, just got one as the lure was falling a little bit there. Kastmaster in the bait fish series with a chartreuse stripe down the center. Yeah. Doesn't feel gigantic, but he's there. He hit it once and I missed him and let it sink back down and he whacked it again. God, these are fun. Not bad. It's not no tail dancer like like the ones earlier, but hey, he just grew. Beautiful.
Yeah. Nice looking Stampede Reservoir rainbow.
For today's fishing, we recommend the Cousins Angler West 801 and 901 rods. Dial Alexa 100 line counter reels. P-Line fluorocarbon 8-pound leader. Maruto sickle style number 4 hooks. And Procure Sweet Shrimp Bait Waxx. Welcome back to the mountains of Northern California. I'm Justin Wolf. There are several smaller lakes in the region that have great trout fishing in them. This afternoon, we're with Marc Christophel and Adam Birdwell, along with Clara Rickaball, in search of some of the area's best trout fishing.
We're up here out on a local lake here in the Truckee area. There's a creek channel right here, holds a lot of rainbows. So we're gonna come up here, we're gonna do a little casting with some Kastmasters, see if we can hook a few. There's a ton of fish in here. Yeah, so what we got here is Nightcrawler, Procure Bait Waxx. That should do pretty well with that Rattlemaster right there. Over this last week, we were just out here last week, and the water's come up significantly out here. A lot of snow runoff, and they're letting it out of the reservoir upstream. So as you can see right here, we've got a lot of debris in the water. The water's a little bit stained. So you know, we'll probably lead with some brighter colors, see if they can get the trout to take a bite on this. All right, little Kastmaster action with the Nightcrawler Bait Waxx. Feels like we have a nice little trout on the other end. Let's see what's going on. Yeah, hey, you know, respectable. Hey, they fall for it, I love it. We'll just release him boat side. So right here, what we have is a natural bait fish pattern from Kastmaster. Kastmaster, a little bit of chartreuse in it with the water the way it is. It's a little bit stained. I figured go with something a little bit bright, reflective. Just an all-out great lure right there. Look at this, starting to tee it up. Let me know if you need the net up there. Wow, that is a beautiful fish. Hey, Claire. Woo-hoo! Way to do it. Bright colors again. That's what this can produce. Absolutely gorgeous fish. Well done. What Clara just caught was a real nice hold over a wild rainbow. Very dark. You know, my guess is it's probably post spawn, but beautiful hold over rainbow, about 16 inches. That's what we really like to see in this reservoir, and we have been seeing, you know, as of recent. So fantastic looking fish.
I had a little bit of sweet shrimp on there. That really worked, so let me put on some more.
Yeah, something I really like about this this bait wax is that it's super sticky. It stays on your lure after cast multiple times, after fish hookups. You can see right here, it's still on my lure, and that was probably at least 3 dozen casts ago. So not only is it effective, but in this kind of cold temperature water too, it'll last on that lure for quite some time.
Okay, so what I was doing when that fish hit was reeling in and then twiddling the lure a little bit.
Jumper! No! Oh! Wow. Get a net.
Yeah.
Oh, another beautiful rainbow.
Yeah, nice on that work. Bait fish pattern with the chartreuse stripe. Yeah, you know, this chartreuse bait fish pattern from Kastmasters is doing real well in addition to that perch with the stained water. These fish are really going after these lures aggressively. And you know, I know a secret is I put in a little bit of sweet shrimp on that last cast. So I followed Claire's advice and nice, beautiful rainbow.
It's that twiddling again. I just can't twiddle enough. So much fun.
That's a nice one.
Yeah, they like that perch.
Yeah. Perch pattern, Kastmaster here. She releases that nice rainbow she just hooked up. Second one on that with the Nightcrawler Bait Waxx.
So with this 7-foot rod here, you can really throw these Kastmasters a long ways. I guess I found the good spot of the lake here. Every time I make a cast that way, they're just waiting for me. Boys,
wow.
I'm getting jealous now.
Another gorgeous one.
See if we can get the net to help me out and help the fish out.
Another nice bow. Same perch Kastmaster.
That sweet shrimp. Sorry, boys. That's three.
Way to go, Clara. Tearing it up.
Nice bow.
Hey, thanks for watching today's episode. You know, without the support of the sponsors, the show would not be possible. So please thank them when you can. Now, get out there and do some great fishing.